two children on at opposite end of an aluminium rod. One strikes the end of the rod with a stone. Find the ratio of time taken by the sound wave in air and the aluminium to reach the second child. And here I am showing an aluminium rod, and a child A is on the left side and a child B on the other side, and this rod is going to be the aluminium rod. A stone, okay, with the help of a stone we are disturbing the aluminium rod so that the any disturbance, no, that will be propagated in the form of wave. And so here it's going to be the sound wave, and but the sound wave, no, traveled in two different medium. So and the surrounding medium of the rod, that is going to be air, and the another medium is aluminium. So two different mediums are there. So and the sound travels in air, okay, as well as in the aluminium rod. Okay, how much time it takes to travel from A to the B, okay, child A to the B through air, that I am going to take it as t air. And how much time it takes to reach from A to B inside the aluminium medium, that I am going to take it as PALU. Okay, ALU stands for aluminium. So I want to calculate the expression for T air and T aluminium, and then I am going to take the ratio of the two to solve the problem. Okay, I hope you understood. So it's a aluminium rod, and with the help of a stone, I'm creating a sound. The sound travels in both the medium, in aluminium rod as well as in the air. I want to take, because the velocity of sound, it is very high in aluminium, it is very low in air. So because of that, no, and there is a difference in timing for it to reach. Through the aluminium, the sound reaches very quickly than in the case of air. So we are going to take the ratio and coming to a conclusion, okay. So that is what we are going to perform now. So we know the speed formula, speed of the wave, v is equal to d by t, and t is equal to d by v. Then the time taken, now I got an expression for time, velocity and the distance it travel. And in this problem, the distance traveled by the sound through the aluminium as well as in the air, that's going to be same. So d remains constant here. The distance traveled is going to be constant. So now I am going to do the time taken by the sound to reach child B through air . So this one I am designated as T air, and that's given by D by V air. Okay, V air is nothing but the velocity of the sound in air. So I know the velocity of sound in air, that is equal to 340 meters per second. So T air, that is equal to D by 340. This one I am going to mark it as equation number 1. Next, I am going to do a similar calculation for the aluminium rod, and the velocity of the sound wave in the aluminium rod, that is given by 6420 meters per second. The time taken by the sound to reach child B through aluminium rod T aluminium that is equal to D by velocity of the sound wave in the aluminium rod. And I know that V aluminium that is equal to 6420 meters per second. So time taken in the aluminium rod that is equal to D by 6420. I am going to mark this one as equation number 2. And taking the ratio equation 1 by 2. So I know that equation 1 T air equal to D by 340. So T air divided by T aluminium that is equal to D by 340 into 6420 by D, cancelling the distance and dividing the equation, I am going to have 18.88. So I can write an equation, the time taken in air that is equal to 18.88 times time taken in aluminium. So as a conclusion, I can say the sound wave, takes 18.88 more times slower than aluminium to reach the child B.
Subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon for important updates.